The fourth and fifth formers of the Troumaca Ontario Secondary School were brought up to date on the construction of the Argyle International Airport. They also heard about some of the work that has to be done in 2011.
Now, at the end of 2010, we had completed some 65% of the earthworks that we need to do at Argyle. We have completed the preparation of the area where we're going to build the terminal building. And this year, we'll continue work on the mountains in the first kilometer of the site. We will also be continuing work on the aprons and the taxiways. We're going to be installing a stone crushing plant so we could crush all the stones that we need to use at Aga, because we do have the stones, so we'll be doing the crushing ourselves so we can use in the paving of the runway. We will also begin work on the city fences at the northeastern end of the runway, because we have to protect the runway and we have to protect the coastal line so that we do not cause any destruction out there. So we have to work on those during 2011. So this year is going to be a busy, busy year for us. And as we go along, we are hoping that all St. Vincent will be behind us and support us. Of course, we have to start the terminal building this year, and we are looking to start the terminal building, if not by the end of January, certainly by February. Don't know how many of you listened to the press conference yesterday from the Prime Minister, but you would have heard, or I will tell you now, that the project would be further delayed by 6 months. So rather than July 2012, we are now looking at December 2012. Why? Precisely because the terminal building construction was delayed. We are delayed by some 7 months with the construction of the terminal building. So once that is on the way, and we're working simultaneously with the Cubans to finish the runway, we should be able to complete the project by December 2012. So that is the new date that we are looking at. We will not begin operations in December 2012, since this is more than likely going to take us down to the end. So we're looking at beginning operations by early 2013. So I think even if we're delayed a few months, once you get your airport, I think we should all still be happy. But definitely, you know you're getting the airport.
Having been brought up to date with where we are currently, attention was then turned to exactly what the airport means to students. How do they take advantage of this project?
It's your fourth and fifth formers. You're getting ready to leave school, and you're wondering, when I leave school, what is going to happen to me or for me in St. Vincent? And there is a big project called the Argyle International Airport. How is that going to help me? Now, I will tell you here how it can help you and how you can help yourselves by preparing early for what is going to happen here. Because we expect that once the international airport is operational, that there will be a lot of jobs one way or the other created indirectly or directly through the establishment of this airport. We are looking at St. Vincent taking off and moving by leaps and bounds. And we are going to require a lot of skills, a lot of trained people. And if where you are now, you can start focusing on your career and take the subjects that you know you need to take to get you where you want to go. If community college or technical college or some other college is going to help you, you start focusing on that. By the time you are ready, you should be in a good position to take advantage of what is coming.
Students also heard about the anticipated increased tourism sector and increased opportunities for farmers to make more money.
Well, something for you to think about. I know a lot of people, young people don't think about getting into agriculture, and they shy away from it because it doesn't look like clean work, but it is actually something to think about doing. Because when the airport takes off, agriculture will take off. When the tourism industry expands, you have more people coming to St. Vincent. They want local foods. We're going to require more food. Not just for them, but we have to continue eating. So they need more food for them, more food for us. Farmers will be able to supply the hotels. Right now, the farmers who supply in Bukoma cannot supply Bukoma when they really need. They still have to import. They don't have enough. The supply is too small. And also, farmers will have the opportunity to get their goods overseas in quick time and make a lot more money. Right now, they can't really ship much. because they don't have the air access. But when the airport opens up, that they will be able to do. So farmers would really be in a good position to make some money. They'll have to look at increasing their farm sizes as well so they could produce enough to supply the market. Hundreds of workers will be needed to operate the Argyle International Airport, literally. So there we are, right at the airport, directly creating jobs for persons. And let us look at some of the things. Start thinking about your career choice and begin preparing for it. If you're planning to pursue a career in engineering, what subjects are you taking? And that would go for any career that you're planning to pursue. What are you planning to do? Take subjects that will lead you there. If you're going to community college, decide already what it is you want to do. Don't decide you're going to community college and after the first year, you're saying, but you not really wanted to do nursing. But it's a waste of time. You could have gone straight to nursing school instead of community college. So know what you want to do and then pursue it, all right? And don't waste time. Decide what will help you. Decide what would help you. And going to community college is not a bad move if you know what you want to do. It actually prepares you for your first year if you go to UW or you go to some other college overseas. It prepares you. It gives you a taste of what college life is really like.
Following our discussion, students were given a further opportunity to ask questions.
How would they see? Argyle, is rough and plenty winds are coming in outside. Won't they affect the planes?
Okay, now the roughness of the sea would not affect the planes. It would affect the coastal area if we don't build the sea defenses properly. And that's one of the reasons you have to build proper sea defenses, because the part of the shoulder area for the runway is going to fall into the sea. And we have to do some land reclamation in that area. Therefore, we must build really good sea defenses. Now, the wind at Argyle, we have heard that there is a crosswind at Argyle. Now, we're not sure that there is a crosswind at Argyle and if there is, if it would affect planes. So what we are doing, we are studying the winds at Argyle. You're taking recording data every day and studying the wind pattern, see if it is strong enough to affect small planes. Big planes will not be affected by the wind that we have at Argyle right now. But there is a possibility it may affect small planes. So we are doing the wind studies. So far we have done over 4 years of studies and it's not showing that we need, that planes are going to be affected. Now what we have done in the planning of the airport is to make a contingency for a crosswind runway. So if at the end of the wind studies it shows that the wind will affect small planes, we will build a crosswind runway for small planes. But if it shows that we do not require one, then we simply just don't build one. All the planes will land on the same runway and they should be all right.
Building an international airport is very expensive. So can this country really maintain an international airport?
Through that, we are certainly going to try. Because the spill-offs that the airport will bring is more than worth whatever cost we are going to put into it right now. When you think about the international airport, I want you to think of it as, say, your school, for example, where the government invested money in building the school, but you're not going to see any direct returns from the school. The returns we're going to get is your education, right? Okay. Now, the spill-offs from the airport, as we went through, would be numerous. And therefore, we're going to be generating a lot of business. So you're going to have things that's going to happen at the airport. You have concession stands. We're going to be renting spaces out there. You have airport fees, you have landing fees, you have other things that the airport will bring in its own revenue. And we would be able to at least maintain the airport, even though we don't see any profits from it right now.
You too can learn more about the Argyle International Airport and its economic benefits by logging on to our website at www.svgiadc.com. For further information, you can call us at 458-0333.